It was one of Sydney's most precious mysteries that started back in the 1930s. Who is writing the word eternity on the footpaths of our city? The mystery was eventually solved, but the writing in chalk was washed away by the rain or scuffed away by passing boot heels, except for one hidden treasure.
He would rise in the pre-dawn of a Sydney morn to walk the streets of the CBD, a stick of chalk at his fingers, and on walls and footpaths he would write one word, eternity. After hearing the word from a fiery preacher in 1932, Arthur Stace would spend the next 35 years scribing it to the city's streets, but only one would survive the elements. Inside the GPO clock tower bell.
There it is, Margaret, a little bit of Sydney history.
A little bit of Sydney history, so a huge piece of Sydney history, isn't it? It's a bit of Australian history. You can just basically see the E, the T, the Y, and part of the rest, but it is still there. Believed to be the last eternity that he actually wrote.
As the clock tower undergoes renovation, as part of works undertaken by the Fullerton Hotel, which now occupies the old GPO, it's thought Stace may have found the bell when it was being stored after the tower was taken down at the height of World War II.
No one knows, and it wasn't seen until the church bell was placed back up.
Also part of the refurbishment, the clock tower's original motor is being revived.
This is a mechanism that hasn't been used for some decades.
No, actually we think it's probably hasn't actually ticked like this mechanically since 1989.
But protected from the elements under the bell that chimes the quarter hour, the mark of the man who tattooed a word into Sydney's memory.
This man couldn't read or write, and his message is still here.
Hopefully, for eternity. Mike Dalton, Nine News.